Now, so last days, that's another key word to examine quickly. When you hear the word last days, what comes to your mind? Because so many people have different perspectives of that word last day. But we must stay with the context of scripture, because the scripture defines our understanding of scriptural concepts. So the word last days, many people think last days mean evil days. No, but last days here should be interpreted clearly, because the last days refer to the day of Christ. The last days refers to the day of Christ. In Hebrews chapter 9, the day of Christ. When you read perilous times in the last days, the term perilous times is not the fruit of the last days. That is, it is perilous against the last days. Perilous times against the last days. See it in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 26. Hebrews chapter 9 verse 26. For then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world. But now, once in the end of the world, once in the end of the world, hath he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself at the end of the world. From the foundation, at the end of the age. Last days, end of the age. Last days and end of the age has he appeared. So the last days speak about redemption. When you hear last days, he is not talking about evil times. He's talking about redemption or the finished work of Christ. Anytime you hear the last days, he is talking about the finished work of Christ. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 11. Now all these things happen unto them for examples, and they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. Upon whom the end of the world are come. So last days or end of the world refers to the day of Christ, where Jesus will say, Abraham saw my day and he rejoiced to see my day. Which day? Last days. What are last days? The finished work of Christ, the redemptive plan of God, the close of time. It refers to the close of a period or an event that closes the period. So the last days speaks of an event, or the last days refers to the event of Christ's sacrifice, a conclusion. It refers to the event of Christ's sacrifice or a conclusion. Last days is last days of the promise of God. Last days of the promises of God, or the fulfillment of the promise that God gave. Last days mean the fulfillment of the promise that God gave. Please pay attention. That God gave. That's what the last days refers to. So the last days confidently began at redemption. The redemptive sacrifice of Jesus was the beginning of last days. It was to close up this period, or the fulfillment of the promises that God gave. Look at Acts chapter 2 verse 16. Please pay attention. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. Next verse. That it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God. It shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Last days. I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. When? In the last days. Which was upon his resurrection. Because it is when he rose from the dead that he shed forth his spirit. So the last days is from the redemptive sacrifice of Jesus. The close of a period where promises were being awaited. The fulfillment of that promise is called the last days or the day of Christ, which Abraham saw ahead of time. Notice that in the prophecy of Joel, the word last days was not there. It is, it shall come to pass afterwards. Joel 2:28. It shall come to pass afterwards. It shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. But when Peter was making reference to that text in Acts chapter 2, because that promise had been fulfilled, he called it last days. Because last days is the fulfillment of God's promise, or it is a period of the redemptive sacrifice of Christ. So in the last days, therefore, it refers to the redemptive sacrifice of Jesus. That means the close of the age began to be consummated by what Jesus did. The close of the age began to be consummated by or with what Jesus did. So last days to us is a time of the glory of God. Last days to us is a time of the glory of God. Last days to us is a time of the forgiveness of sins. Last days to us is a time when redemption and the free favors of God abounded to mankind. Last days to us is a time of the sacrifice of Jesus. So when he says, "Hath in these last days," it refers to the sacrifice of Jesus.